Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. First and foremost, we want to give our praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushai, Bashem, Kapodash. You know, double honors to the elders and the apostles of the Redmond School. Salutation to the Akiopushan Shrew, in sincerity to the four corners of the earth. You know, to the world, to Akwas, who is selling, you know, we obedient to the husband, to respect the Israelite, to wake up to the heritage. You know, the brother Howard from the GMS, prophetic by Mishan Kemp. You know, to the spread that boy, Abashem, you know, we come together. And the brother Yakar, which went through Psalms 35. You know, and through the spread, we say, you know, we will go down into it. You know, and bring us up to say, why we're going into it. You know, so, yes, I know.
Yeah, the book of Psalms, chapter 35 and verse 1. It says, Psalms of David, plead my cause, O Yahweh, with them that strive with me, fight against them that fight against me. Yeah, and that is as David crying out unto Yahweh, Shem Yahushai, the Heavenly Father, you know, his shield and buckler, you know, to stand up for his cause. It's a take hold of shield and buckler and stand up for mine help. Draw out also the spear and stop the way against them that persecute me.
God, and which we know who's them, you know, all these other nations, you know, head leading Esau, Edom. You know, Esau, Edom is one of the when I check the chart we make, you know, the 80 nations, Esau, you know, is the one, you know, who say, hey, come the living nation of creation, you know, from you know, the existence, you know, to take up your heritage and say, my God, you know, going down, you know, they're sitting on their own tables and trying to persecute us, you know, watching the program back to the elect, you know, and it really is the whole house of Israel, you know.
Yeah, even when you go back up, right, and read that, it says, plead my cause, O Lord, with them that shy with me, fight against them that fight against me. You understand? That talks about our own people. You understand? Our own people alongside Esau. Because we know we are in a time when nobody is going to be, everybody is going to be an enemy. You understand? Everybody is going to be an enemy. But in the seven edges where everybody against one people against one another. Stand up for my help, draw out also the spear, and stop the way against them that persecute me. Say unto my soul, I am thy salvation. Because we know that they're going to persecute us. And how they're going to persecute us? In many different ways, the scripture break down in the synagogues. They're going to persecute us, you know, for not taking the wicked, the devil's cure. They're going to persecute us in many different ways. They're going to, as the scripture said, they're going to come in your house, spoil your goods. And it's not going to be Esau alone doing that, it's going to be also your own people. Right?
Yeah, and say unto my soul, I am thy salvation, let them be confounded and put to shame that seek after my soul. Yeah, they just because they have Bashem and Shani, the scripture even say that the enemy going to even teach them time. You know, the Lord going to always put measures in a way that you're gonna be delivered and they're gonna be confounded at the end of it, at the end of this whole thing. It said, let them be turned back and put to confusion that device my hurt.
Because when you read it say, let them be confounded and put to shame that seek after my soul, because it's really soul Esau searching for. If you understand, 2/3 of our people, their soul already gone. Because they sell their soul for this system, they sell their soul for this devil's cure. You understand? They come and they sell their birthright, as we always say, they sell, come and sell their soul. This is you selling their soul because they're searching for your life, yeah, but they're searching for your soul. Because you saw what you on this side. Right? You saw what you on this side to take it up, to take you down.
Device my hurt. Let them be as chaff before the wind, and let the angel of Yahweh chase them.
God.
Yeah, and hey, that is just how we know that to Yahweh Hashem angel is sending out his will be done. You know, he go for the let allow the angels, right, to go onto the spirit of Jacob or whatsoever is the case, you know, to fight against one another. That's why you even seen Egypt against Egypt all now, you know.
The spirits on the left.
Yeah,
hand.
Yeah, the spirits on the left hand side. It says, let their way be dark and slippery, and let the angel of the Lord persecute them. And that is the thing about it. This one, Yahweh Shemeshai done already set it, set them, put it, alright, it come like this, you know. They, all this new old agenda, all these things, it is going to come to naught at the end, you know. The triumph and the wicked is good for a moment. So they're going to fall into their own trap that they actually set. And the Lord is going to use the angels, you know, self to persecute them.
Nobody can really go up against the sword, do you understand? The only person that can really go up against the Lord's sword is the Lord himself. Let there will be dark. That dark represents what? Confusion and what? So they can't see. You understand? They can't see it because they plan on this thing for years now. He already set up everything. They know what they're gonna do when the rioting start. They know all these things. You understand? But the Lord said, let their way be slippery. Right? Let the angel of the Lord persecute them. And how do you can persecute them by ruining and crushing all the things that they say they're gonna have something done? You understand? Just for the election.
And just to add, you know, just to add, because as you say, you know, whereby they try, it's gonna fall on them. And spiritually, you know, and lies one where Esau, Edom, you know, is you know, is staying up in his pretty most for, because we are getting picked up, the elect is getting sealed, you know. We are coming back to Yahweh Shemesh, calling upon the true power, Yahweh Shemesh, well, the true power is Israel, which is Yahweh Shemesh, you know, the Hebrew tongue. So I'll bring all the scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter 1. Yeah, 1 Corinthians 1 verse 27. It says, but Yahweh had chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. It says, and Yahweh had chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty. So we know that Esau, Edom, you know, you don't bring that spirit. As you say, you don't give the power. So like, yeah, you know, you see Job 9 and 24, it is given to the hands of the wicked. So the Lord give the wicked, which is Esau, Edom, that power, you know, that power, that might on the earth to rule, you know. So, you know, the Lord using the weak, you know, to come against the strong. How we doing it spiritually? As many Lord, the Lord revealing that secrets unto the servants. We breaking down the scriptures, and we actually, you know, figuring out Esau, you know, we figuring out Esau, you know. It's good getting lifted up, because we see that, hey, the hyperinflation is getting ready to take place, you know, farming ready to take place, you know. The pestilence, which we know that is job we pushing now right now, you know, when it turn on that frequency, you know, everybody gonna be like zombie, you know, everybody gonna be, you know, chipping off, you know, everybody gonna be running like, you know, like I am legend, you know. Because in that time we're heading in, it's a serious time. Because Esau, which we know, is that deceiver. You know, and the only person he can deceive is really the 2/3 and these other nations, but not the elect. You know, so we don't take that.
Yeah, it's it. And base things of the world and things which are despised. And hey, the scriptures say, hey, gather yourself, O nation, on this desired. And I just show you the trainer Israel. Look at the situation that these Jakes is, we under the curses and all these things, but Yahweh Shemeshai had kept a remnant that would be able to understand this knowledge and do the will of Yahweh Shemeshai. Let's see. And these things of the world and things which are despised had Yahweh Shemeshai chosen. Because hey, we remain a spectacle on the world, unto the world. You know, we are the least, the last. And say yea, and things which are not, to bring to naught things that are. Yeah. So we being that spectacle as being the kitchen next to nothing, the Lord is gonna make us something. You know, the Lord is gonna glorify us, and with that knowledge, He is gonna, you know, through His will, we are gonna bring down Esau, Edom, here. You know, the spiritual house of David rising back up with the men being filled with this knowledge. That no flesh should glory in His presence.
And which we know, you know, as the scripture say, you know, no flesh and blood can inherit the kingdom of heaven. So we know that Esau, Edom, and other nations cannot inherit the kingdom of heaven. You know, because we're going to be transfigured. You know, we're going to get transfigured in our extraterrestrial body. You know, so we're going on into this, hey, this shop, this Psalms 35, hey, powerful. You know, go down into that.
Yeah, it says, for without cause they have hid for me their net in a pit, which without cause they have digged my soul. Yeah, and that's just it. They set up the system. That's their pit. They actually dig for all these jakes. You know, the way how they set up society and all these things, you know, is always to keep the jakes down. Keep Jake's transgressing Yahweh Hashem and Shai laws. It say, which without cause they have digged for my soul. And that is just how the devil setting up all his measures, you know, to take all you Israelites, you know, let you sign a covenant with the devil.
Yeah, can, because it say for without the cause have they hid for me their net. And we know what a net is, a trap. It goes into a snare, right? Many different ways Esau could come for you. Many different ways that he could get you. You understand? Because if he don't get you with by just making it mandatory, he'll get you by him making it your children have to take it. And then it has some people depending on money from the government. They'll make you put it like you had to get that to get your money from the government. You had to get that to go in the grocery. You gotta get that to go here and go there.
And the MOTB.
Can.
Because it's the main thing you gotta come with.
Can. Like the biggest snare which they have in our pit right now. But we know Esau crafty, so it's many things, many different things you're gonna come with. Right? Right? It's say for me, their net, they hit for me, their net in the pit, which without cause they have digged for my soul. It's say let destruction come upon him at unawares, yeah? Why destruction gonna come on him unaware? Because he's so hellbound on knowing that he in rulership. That pride reached to the brain, you understand? That pride reached to the heavens and what? Because he saw that pride of belief. It's gonna move his way, you understand? If he take it up his way, not knowing that it's not gonna move his way, he can set up a space force, right? And that space force is to make him feel that when the Lord return, you're gonna try to shoot down the Lord. But that's not gonna work. None of your plans gonna work. When you read Revelation, I'm Revelation. When you read Isaiah 14, you understand? You got a brief understanding of how the Lord gonna take down Esau. All your plans gonna fail. That's why it say, let destruction come upon him at unawares. Even when the ICBMs hit, you understand? All that gonna be at unawares because you're thinking your dome gonna be so strong to defend it. When your dome not gonna be strong at all. The Lord gonna make sure everything you set up. Confound, yeah, set it to confusion.
Yeah, the book of Ezekiel chapter 20:6. It says, therefore, thus saith the Lord, because thou hast set thy heart as the heart of power or of God, behold, therefore I will bring strangers upon thee, the terrible of the nations, and they shall draw their swords against the beauty of thy wisdom, and they shall defile thy brightness.
And so you actually see that China is one raising up right now. China is raising up, Iran is raising up, you know, North Korea is raising up, Russia is raising up, you know, all these nations are raising up, right? They're going to the valley of Joseph, you know, and that brightness is they're going back into your mind, going back into your power, going back into your system, you know, where you set, you know, all embassies, you know, coming to all these other countries and bringing it with our embassies. and they want to rule that nation. You know, rule that city. So that is show Esau, Edom, you know, hey, these nations realizing that hey, he, you know, is the wicked. You know, he wanna do what's best for him, and he don't care about, you know, what's best for no one else. So they're actually saying that, you know, and even when we go into the scripture, they say that they vex because they take up, they partake in us into slavery.
Say for the nations have drunken and therefore the nations are mad. Can't. Because they vex that they even take part in the Israelites into slavery. Can't. And even that scripture we was just reading, we say, verse 7, behold, I will bring strangers upon thee, the terrible of the nation, and they shall draw their swords against thy beauty of that wisdom. They shall defile the brightness. Can't, because Esau going in a transitioning from brightness into darkness. All now you're seeing Esau darkness getting dim. You understand? He getting so dim right now that it's not even looking good anymore.
Can
everybody exposing him? Go ahead and say yes. Yeah.
Can, because when he read it slowly, it say, and they shall draw their swords against thee because of thy wisdom. And what is this devil wisdom? It's the technology and all these things. And look at right now, China more advanced, Russia more advanced in the technologies and the nuclear weapons and all these things.
That's why they want to see that China does that.
Meaning that it's not going to miss. So I would bring all this precept putting into that as well. The book of Job 18 and 17. It says, his remembrance shall perish from the earth. Let's see if I get it one time. I would read it from here, right? It says, his remembrance shall perish from the earth. He shall have no name in the street. You understand? So in other words, he doesn't have no street cred, right? So